Hi, and welcome to National Library Week at the Campbell County Public Library. Every year during National Library Week, our children's staff puts together a puppet show. So we've been doing puppet shows live all week at our story time sessions. And if you weren't able to be here, or maybe you don't actually live in Gillette, we thought you might want to watch a video of our puppet shows here on YouTube. So we're glad that you're here today. And I just want to invite you to sit back, enjoy our puppet show. We're going to have a little stretcher in the middle after the first puppet show before the second performance, and we'll enjoy a visit under the sea.
Public Library Children's Department presents The Three Little Fishies and the Big Bad Shark, adapted from The Three Little Fish and the Big Bad Shark by Ken Geist. In the deep blue sea, three little fishies lived happily with their mama. But the day came when their mama told them, sadly, it was time for them to go out into the world. Mama told the three little fishies to build good, strong houses to protect them from the big bad shark.
Oh my, wasn't it awful to see Mama so sad like that?
Well, it was really sad news. Mama wants us to go out on our own. I'm not sure if I'm big enough.
I hope you were listening carefully to what Mother told us about going off on our own. She said we must build our houses where we will be safe and secure from the big bad shark.
Aw, sharks, Mark. I'm not afraid of that toothy troublemaker.
Me either. That shark doesn't scare me. The first little fish and the second little fish started to swim up and down and all around the third little fish, and they started to sing.
Who's afraid of the big bad shark? Who's afraid of the big bad shark?
You two should be afraid of the big bad shark. After all, he does eat little fish.
Nah, don't be such a worrywart, fish.
Yeah, we can look after ourselves.
Remember, you promised Mother you would build yourselves a good strong house so the shark won't be able to get inside and eat you for dinner.
You're not Mama. You don't have to worry about me. I'll just follow the path to the left.
And me? I can stand on my own two fins. I'll take the path to the right. I'm sure that's the best one.
I won't forget, Mother. I will build myself a good strong home, and I'll follow that path there, the straight and narrow one.
Little did the three little fishies know that they had been watched by a shark.
Did I just see three little fishes go by?
Yummy! I think I'm hungry. Maybe a fish casserole, or fish and chips, or fish tacos.
This looks like a good place to settle down. There's plenty of food nearby, and I won't even have to build a real house. I'll just hollow out a space in the seaweed and live inside. That won't take any work at all. There. Instant housing. Oh, what a smart fish I am. Now I'll just go inside and take a nap.
What do you kids think? Did the first little fishy build a good, strong house to protect herself from the shark?
No.
Oh no, here comes the shark.
I smell something so good. Hey kids, is it chicken I smell? How about rabbit?
No.
Fish?
Yes.
Yes, it's definitely fish. Little fish, let me in.
Oh, not by the scales on my finny fin fin.
Then I'll splash, and I'll thrash, and I'll smash your house down.
Oh, no. My house? Where is my seaweed house?
got away.
That was a close call for the first little fish. She barely escaped the jaws of that big bad shark. Let's see how the second little fishy's house building is going. I have been swimming forever, and I still haven't found a good house to live in. I guess I'll have to build my own house after all. Let me see. Oh my. There are a lot of shells around here. I'll just build my house out of seashells. There. I'm sure this will be just fine. Well, this house building is a lot of work and no fun at all. I think I'll just go inside for a much needed nap now. Oh, kids, do you think the second little fishy built a good, strong house for protection from the shark?
No.
Oh, no. Here comes the shark again.
Maybe this is my lucky day after all. Yes, sir. I see fish and chips for supper and fish ice cream for dessert. Little fish, let me in.
Oh, not by the scales on my fitty fin fin.
Then I'll splash, and I'll thrash, and I'll smash your house down.
Oh no, I don't want to be fish sticks, and I don't want to be fish ice cream either. Ah!
Stop, my little fish stick. I'll get you! Rats! She got away!
Wow, that was a very close call for the second little fish. She had barely escaped the jaws of the big bad shark. Let's see how the third little fishy's house building is going.
Gosh, I wonder how my two fishy sisters are doing. I hope they listened to Mother and built themselves strong, safe homes. Well, I guess I should start building my home. Now, let's see. What could I use to build a good, strong home? What to use? Rocks? Oh, why, yes. Rocks would make a wonderfully strong home. And there are plenty of rocks on the bottom of the sea. I'll use these fine stones to build me a home, because I promised my mother that I'd never roam. There's a big bad shark who'll eat me up fast unless I build a house that will last and last and last. My goodness, these rocks are heavy, but a good strong house is worth all the work. There, a shark-proof house. Now I'll just go inside and finish up the kitchen.
Oh, kids. Do you think the third little fishy built a good, strong house to protect her from the shark?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh no, here comes that big bad shark.
I smell a yummy fish sandwich. And this time, I'm not going to let it get away. Little fish, let me in.
No, sir, not by the scales of my finny fin fin.
Well, then I'll splash, and I'll thrash, and I'll smash your house down. Maybe I'll try chomping your house down. Oh, my teeth!
Go ahead, Mr. Shark. You'll break every tooth before you chew this house down.
Not so fast, my beautiful herring. I haven't really tried yet. I'll thrash and I'll chew. Oh, my poor teeth! Oh, my poor sore fins! Oh, my tail!
Who's afraid of the big red shark?
Well, I'm not finished yet. Kids, what do you think I should do?
Give up.
Do you think there's a window I can swim in?
Maybe.
Oh, I'm going to try.
Oh no, I better do something about that toothy shark. I'll get out my canning supplies and...
There, problem solved.
shark in a can. Just think, when the three little fishies get together, they can have shark sandwiches. The end.
I hope you enjoyed that puppet show about the three little fishes and the big bad shark. I think it's a good time for us to stand up and stretch and sing a song about a shark. Can you join me? Let's see if we get somebody to dance with us.
Row your boat. Row your boat. Baby shark. Baby shark.
The Campbell County Public Library Children's Department presents Can I Give You a Squish? Adapted from Can I Give You a Squish? By Emily Neilson. This story begins in the deep blue sea with mermaid family, Kailani and her mama. Kailani gave her mama a big squish. She loves giving squishes.
I love giving squishes.
The rest of the morning, Kailani gave out squishes all over the sea.
I want to squish that big green kelp.
Oh, hi, Narwhal.
Yay, seaweed squishes.
And I'm going to squish that bumpy green rock. Rock squishes rock.
Hey, hermit crab, hanging out by the rocks, I see.
Oh, I'm going to squish that buried treasure. Hey, octopus, are you going to get squishes to the buried treasure too?
Kailani then gave her friends, Narwhal, hermit crab, and octopus, a big group squish. Then Kailani spotted a little puffer fish hiding by the kelp and definitely wanted to squish her too.
Big squish!
Suddenly, the shy fish puffed up like a big balloon with pokey spines all over her body. That is what puffer fish do when they are scared or surprised.
Oh dear, I do not like to be squished.
Kailani felt terrible. All she had wanted to do was give a kind squish, but it had gone terribly wrong. The pufferfish had not liked that squish at all.
Oh, maybe there's something else you can give besides a squish to show that you want to be friends.
What else can I do besides give a friendly squish?
The friends thought, and they considered, and they pondered, and they wondered, until at last it came to them.
A fin bump!
pufferfish was still hiding in the kelp when Kailani swam up.
Excuse me? Hi? I see you don't like squishes. Would you like a fin bump instead?
Oh, hi. I do like getting fin bumps.
Great! I like giving fin bumps too.
What about you guys? What do you like?
I like to do tail claps because no one likes when I do nose boops.
Me too. Great idea, Narwhal. Nose boops may not be a good choice, but I love tail claps. Octopus, what do you like?
Well, I like a nice tentacle shake.
So Kailani gave Octopus a firm yet friendly tentacle shake. It was different than a squish, but enjoyable.
Hey, does anybody want a claw pinch?
Maybe just a little claw pinch, Hermit Crab.
Kailani watched as all her friends shared different kinds of squishes, and that's when she realized
every fish likes their own kind of squish.
Thanks for a great day, everyone. Bye, friends.
Bye.
See you later. Bye. Kailani went to find Mama to show her what her friends learned. Kailani gave Mama a fin bump and a tail clap and a tentacle shake and even a little claw pinch.
Thanks, Bubble. Those are all great. But I think I would rather have a big squish.
Okay, Mama.
Kailani was so happy Mama wanted a big squish, and she will never forget that each fish likes their own kind of squish. The end.
Enjoyed our puppet shows that took us under the sea a little bit today. We'd like to say thank you to Gillette Public Access Television for helping us with our sound recording for our puppet show, as they do every year. And of course, thank you to our wonderful, talented children's librarian puppeteers for helping us with our performances this week. We hope that you've had a good time. Happy National Library Week, and thank you for joining us. Bye. Bye.